Well, maybe from your perspective, it would be nice if you can maybe go through like the teacher perspective, because of course you're the expert.
Yeah, as a teacher, it's quite the same. You can set up like Ananda showed you already. We've seen the video, and is it coming up? Yeah, you showed this one from teacher perspective or student perspective, and here you can see also what your students have done. That's the information you really want to have before you start your online lecture. You can publish the grades, but that's helpful. But for me, it's more that I know who is engaged and who's not. It's also possible to download those information out of the feedback food environment. Then you get it nicely in Excel, and you know exactly who was working on this assignment.
Yeah, and if you click on the drop down above there, you'll see indeed the statistics, the activity statistics. So did they view it indeed? Were the questions answered? And total amount of comments. Yeah,
exactly. So then you know as a teacher what your students are or did before the lecture started online. And that's great to do with online or interactive video, but also all the other tools we have, peer review by a teacher. I'll show that one, sure, which is also great. And actually, when you really want them to peer review each other, maybe I don't want to watch here as a teacher, only if there are questions.
Do it as a student?
Yeah, show me.
It's the other one that's still called teacher. Yeah.
There we go. As a here you have the instructions again. Of course, they first have to hand in a file.
You can do that.
And then, yeah, and which file can I hand in? Tools overview.
Tool overview. Yeah, perfect.
Yeah, that's great. And there we go. And that's handed in. And then you see I have, or a student has to add a file before he can give feedback. So he really has to do his job before he can start giving feedback to his peers. So we can have a look at one of...
I think the other one might be nicer, this one.
Yeah, this one is... well, that's a good job.
do you see when you use it as a teacher, then students actually learn better that way?
Well, it's always hard to get students working this way also, so we have to train them in it, but when they are used to it, I think learning goes deeper than normally. Yeah.
Yeah, I can imagine.
Yeah, but it's a skill that we have to develop by our students in the years that we have them with us.
Yeah,
but we have them 4 years normally.
Yeah, so true, but it will benefit them for life, right?
Yeah. For sure.
Well, giving feedback skills are soft skills, which are part of the 21st century skills and just a very important element indeed of learning, of work that you need to obtain. And what you'll see here in this peer feedback session is really those scaffold step-by-step approach, students being helped, getting tips on how to give constructive feedback, also being able to get reflections on how they did their feedback. And what you will see, I'm not sure if you noticed this already, but the tools are in interface quite similar, although they support completely different use cases, because our core goal as Feedback Foods is to take away the technological burden, because it should be pedagogy first. We should talk about course design. We should talk about how are we going to activate students. Technology shouldn't be a hurdle anymore in the implementation of that. So that's why there's a uniform design, well integrated into Teams. Also for the student approach, trying to really help them through that scaffold approach by showing the progress, by showing, okay, this is your next step. Our average completion rates are also really high, and often we get teachers being quite amazed by that, like, whoa, 95%? Are you sure that data is correct? But the thing is, if you get students started and you make it really easy just to continue and then finish it, you get these high completion rates, because you try to remove all those technological hurdles that people normally walk into, and they can be silly small things, but still they sort of stop you in your this smooth learning, right? That's an element which is really important, that if you have your cognitive load, well, sorry to be a bit going into the pedagogy, but all right, we are pedagogy first, first company, if you take the cognitive load, if that gets filled with, oh yeah, I also had to do this, oh yeah, and this was in that browser, and how does this work, and how does the technology work, you sort of, the amount of space that you get to actually learn the subject just reduces.
Yeah.
So yeah, that's one of the, another design design element.
True.
Love that you are so passionate.
Well, in the meantime, I just filled in the peer review, so you see you can give points to your peers, and at least you have to write one comment. It's, as a teacher, you can decide how many comments or how many points they can give each other, on how many questions. We have to write some feedback, so it was a good... Good job, I passed it. As a student, I'm now working as a student to one of my peers. And then if I go back to teacher, it should be showing up here as well. Then I think I have to refresh.
I kind of want to go back to university as a student.
Sorry? Oh, you want to go back?
Yeah, it's
welcome.
You're still
a lot of interest in there.
I consider it,
yeah. Well, become a teacher. And students still in progress. I have to look where it is. Hand in their steps. Well, here you, of course, you see as a teacher, you have your overall view of the work that peers have done.
Yeah, so net, if you open up students still in progress, then you will see the student because they had to do 3 reviews in this case, so they're not done yet. But you can see, get information about how far they are, and yeah.
And you can also set a deadline. It's 4 days left, so you can also see who finished first.
Yeah,
and if you were working through the deadline,
guide students in that. We're setting deadlines for each separate step, so you can set a deadline for hand-in, for giving feedback, and also for reading and reflecting on the feedback. So that's also something that's included in the tool, is that at the end, after they've given feedback, you can ask students to write a reflection about what they've learned. So that's really a great moment for students to kind of stand still and think, oh yeah, what did I learn from this like activity and this feedback process? And in that way, really, yeah, make sure that they read the feedback and do something with it.
Yeah. I have another audience question for you, Ralph.
Okay.
Like, how often do you use feedback groups? Like, is it once a day, once a week? How much would you use it?
It depends highly on the course that I'm giving. So there are courses that I'm not using feedback groups at all. But that was also in the time that there was no COVID. For the year starting, I think I will use it probably for every lesson. I'm still plotting out my lessons for the coming block, but I really need to use it because I really want to engage my students, and I really want to know on forehand which of my students are working and not. And that was a possibility that I didn't use in before the summer break, because at that moment it was okay, we're going online. And we just needed all the time to only think about, okay, what are we doing anyway? And how are we going to do that? And now there's a little bit more time. I have a little bit more rest, think about my course design. So I will use one of these tools for every lesson. Sometimes just very short, but I want to be sure who's there at that moment, who already is engaged before we see each other online.
Cool. Thank you.
And what we try to do with the tooling is make it really easy for teachers that don't have a lot of headspace at the moment, which I understand, just to make a small step like this small improvement. For example, you already use videos, add some questions to it, that's it. You will already see some difference. Peer feedback is something that you that's not something you just turn on. You should really think about this. This is a use case pedagogy that that you should think through before you actually start using it. The tool itself, you can start using it from just a basic perspective, right? Really basic, and then work out more in depth if you want to. We try to make sure it's this first step is as easy as possible, but can become a bit more advanced. How you like it. So it tries to really facilitate in this transition in course design with the first step, but also with the more advanced, if you're saying I really reflect on trying to use some of these learning activities in my whole course. That is quite advanced already as a teacher.
Still small. I'm not using all of them, and which one? I think it's really important. I say it again, to know which of my students are engaged in front of my online lecture and who's not, so I can take action on that. But also, what I really love is the interactive presentation. We already have our presentations ready or working on it, mostly in PowerPoint. And now you can take your PowerPoint into Feedback Foods, and in your lecture, your online lecture, you can stop it and ask questions at your lecture. So it's not always in advance, it can be in the online lecture as well. Yeah. And that takes, yeah, it takes a little bit of time, but not that much. So it's very easy to start with it and use it, and then you go further and it gets more advanced.
Great.